This morning in our series, School Matters, we take you to an unlikely hotbed of high-tech education, Wilder, Idaho, with a population of about 1,700. The school district in this tiny farm town is one of only a handful across the country to personalize how kids learn, and it uses tech tools in the whole district. Wilder was just named one of the 25 most innovative districts in America. But as John Blackstone reports, technology is just one part of a new formula that is energizing students.
School buses are almost the only thing about education that hasn't changed in Wilder, Idaho. Students here spend much of their time learning to use 3D printers, studying robotics, or creating animated movies.
Quiet on set.
Using the same technology as Hollywood studios.
So double tap it.
Instead of everyone learning the same subject at the same time, at Wilder, each student is working on a different subject using their individual iPads.
So reading, writing, arithmetic, it's all going on.
Everything's going on, yes.
Every student studies independently, but always watched closely by their teacher, as Wyatt Kraft knows well.
And the teacher can always tell what you're doing.
She's like a hawk.
In this class, that hawk is sixth grade teacher Stephanie Bauer, who uses her iPad to monitor everything every student in her class is doing.
Those of us who learned in traditional classroom often thought the teacher has eyes in the back of her head.
Yes.
You really do.
I do. So I can see if a student is answering too fast or if they're just stuck on a screen.
And any science. Right.
It's part of a new approach called personalized learning, and Superintendent Jeff Dillon thinks it fixes the flaws of traditional education.
You're treating most of the kids exactly the same way, on the same page, day after day after day, and those kids that are above are bored and waiting around, and those kids behind get left behind.
Okay. Now each student can learn at a pace that is right for them.
We live in a society that personalizes everything we do. Why isn't education personalized?
But you can't have one teacher for each student.
But you can use the technology to bridge that gap.
10 years ago, Wilder Elementary was one of the lowest performing schools in the state, and more than half the students didn't have internet at home. But then, 3 years ago, the district applied for and won a grant from Apple. Other tech giants like Sprint and educational toys company Sphero soon followed.
We need to take technology and really begin to get our students on the same playing field as the private schools that can afford sometimes more for their kids. Our kids deserve the same playing field.
It's too early to see if all this technology will improve test scores.
We're not trying to boost a test score here. We're trying to change a narrative for students.
All right, I'll see you later.
When Jessica Cole brought her son Wyatt here, he'd been in constant trouble at his previous school.
Okay.
Now he's thriving.
He's just blossoming, and it's happening so fast. I mean, it's kind of shocking.
He used to think he was stupid?
Yeah, he didn't have very good self-esteem. And now he feels like he's part of something important.
Are you trying to create computer programmers? Are you trying to create animators or screenwriters? What are you trying to create?
Opportunities is what we're trying to create.
An important change for one small school district in Idaho, and a big idea for education nationwide. For CBS This Morning, John Blackstone, Wilder, Idaho.
Such a smart series that we're doing.
So
you know, talk about what works, you know, what's working in school districts. We need to share these ideas, do more of these positive stories. People are doing great work.
Smart series that we're doing, and very smart thing what they're doing there. I love Mrs. Bauer the hawk, because you really do feel the teacher has eyes in the back of her head. It makes sense that you would individualize personal education for these kids. Mm-hmm. I like this idea a lot.
And if a kid gets fired up about one thing, then they can go and take that to other endeavors. But if they never get that first spark, then it's hard.
Mm-hmm. I never sparked in algebra, John.
Well, that's okay. You're like a sparkler in so many other ways, Gail.
I never sparked in algebra.